There is absolutely no greater an experience than being on your own, surviving on your gut instinct and thus achieving a sense of independence we all wish we had. For about 100 kilometers, the river Kali in Kumaon has absolutely no link with the outside world, which means if you decide to run this stretch of river, your companions, deserted beaches and your raft would be all you'd have, except of course the rapids themselves.
Never imagine where I am. You'll scream when you hear who I'm with.
This is the mission. Mission from God.
Don't try this at all.
I'm not nervous at all. I'm looking forward to this.
Right now, I just miss my mom.
1, 2, 3, let it go! We did it!
Very easy going, but it's gonna get tough.
It'll look dangerous when we do it, because we don't know how to do it.
Yes!
Trapped in my body,
trapped in my body,
trapped in my soul,
trapped in my soul,
trapped in my body,
trapped in my body,
and I think I'm getting old. Trapped in a dream and you can't even scream, cause there's no one.
Our journey from Julagarh to Tanakpur is 115 kilometers over 4 days. That's roughly 30 kilometers a day. When the water is placid, it's hard work and you have to paddle a lot. When the current takes over, it's smooth sailing. From here on, it's goodbye to civilization. No phones, no fax, no cell phone. Even money doesn't work here. Only barter. Keeping that in mind, we brought along our musicians. You know, to sing for their supper.
This is the trip of a lifetime that everybody has to make. Down the Kali River, India's right there. That's Nepal. And everything's wonderful.
To be an illegal alien in these parts, all you need are dried pumpkins. And you can float back and forth between India and Nepal. What's more, you can take in fabulous sunsets lying on your back. Looks like day one had a lot in store for us.
36 kilometer run till the conference at Pancheshwar with the Saryu, and it's completely breakthrough section, not too big rapids,
and the whole inside of stalactites coming up.
Still in God we trust again.
He has a village here, a family here, he has a family there.
To thank them.
Alright, here we are at a Nepalese village, a village on the Nepal side of the river.
What?
Do
you tell me good morning? Sonia village.
And are there any other villages?
Only
2 houses.
Yeah.
Man, that's a big village.
Biyaha re pachi tala le. Biyaha re yo naak ko launu par sa.
Hi.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Madam, they have put a weight on the strip here.
Rangu.
Vote for Rangu, new mayor in council.
Yes, Kate.
Guncho.
And you? Kyo name is
Choro.
Choro.
So Rangu and Guncho started their own little family out here.
Villages on this section of Mahakali are hard to come by, and we were lucky to camp so close to one. In fact, this was the only village we managed to stop at on our entire trip.
Lala, this is the big one, huh?
Yeah, this is the big one at Chuka, yeah.
Chuka's finally here. So
the biggest one on the trip.
What class do you make this one to be?
We're about a 4 class. With a very tight lineup and entry.
Do you think we can make it through this one?
Yeah, let's see. Let's hope so.
Yeah. And as we watched nervously, JD took the first plunge. Following closely behind were the three river guides, Kala, Sanjay and Anvesh. Morning, it was unusually misty and dull, and yet it was warm. Kala said this was an indication that we had descended to the plains.
Seagull, you fly across the horizon into the misty morning sun. Nobody asks you where you are going. Nobody knows when. A man asking questions, is this really the end of the world? Seagull, you must have known for a long time the shape of things to come, and you fly through the sky, never ask your why.
Alright, it looks like this is it. Finally, after 5 days on the river Kali, starting far up north from Julaghat, coming all the way down to Boom, which is our pullout, and it's been the most remarkable, one of the most remarkable times, experiences of our lives. Looks like we can see those monstrosities that we refer to as jeeps, so we can go back home. I prefer the raft instead.